It's the debate on the lake, Cleveland Brownstown, taking it everywhere.
Welcome to the Debate on the Lake. It is your boy Dre Evans along with B. Clem and my man Y. And today we are going to jump into the Cleveland Browns, the NBA lottery, playoffs, and Mac Wilson. Guys, thank you so much for joining the show today because it's your show. And
glad to be here.
Training camp. Let's talk about training camp.
Well, my big thing is, like last year and every year since the Browns got back, all I'm hoping for is a healthy, when it first started, was a healthy training camp. And so far, that hope has been lightweight, kind of dwindled slightly with the hurt, Chubb getting hurt, Mac Wilson getting hurt, Gary getting hurt. But through good doctoring, so to speak, they ball over most of my back. They just released Johnson out the from the hospital. I'm hoping Mac Wilson don't have to have surgery. So far, he don't get a second opinion, so it's looking like he might not have to have surgery. And that's a big plus for him, because I think we're going to need him. And I've been checking out that tackle that we got. And we switched Wells, to the left Wells, side, Wells. Yeah. And I watched him and Vernon, because I switched Vernon to his side.
Yeah, but they had to take Vernon off.
They had to take Vernon off because they were doing too much. But I'm a strong believer that he need that. I think if he can handle Vernon and if he can handle Garrett at these positions, we ain't got to worry about nobody else coming.
Oh, no question. No question.
You got the two of the best ends. You're going against two of the best ends in the game right now. Most definitely the number two.
Oh, no question.
In the NFL right now. No question. Garrett. No question. If you can hold Garrett off that left side for any amount of time, then I think we'll be all right. Now, as far as receivers and our running back, I think we're pretty solid in that area. I think we just got to get a little more reps in there with each other, the quarterback and the receiver. So far, to me, Chubb, that breakaway, looking real good. The injury he has, still looking pretty good, looking real good. And so far, the whole team. Continuity, it's looking pretty good from what I've seen. You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking forward to the season and this. I do believe that not having a preseason might hurt us a little bit.
Things are going to hurt everybody.
It's going to hurt everybody. But I think no team having a preseason, it might come out a little better for everybody. So that's
Because from what I've been saying, and it's kind of bothering me, Baker Mayfield is not looking good. From a lot of the films that I've been seeing, a lot of the live podcasts is coming from out of the practices. He overthrowing like he was doing last year. I could see that. He sacrificing his receivers. They jumping all up in there to catch his balls. I really don't know what to say about Baker, man. Because everybody else, I mean, Wills, they say Wills is doing decent. Delpit, they say, is playing with the second team, but he getting a lot of first team reps.
Yeah, and he was looking real good, too.
Right. They say Kareem Hunt looked beautiful, you know, in the absence of Chubb. Yeah. And like you say, Chubb just came back and broke a couple.
Right. But you know, B, Baker got a lot on his shoulder. I believe he got a lot on his shoulder.
With
coming from the season he had last year. Let's go from his first season to the second season.
Right.
To this third season. Not only do he got to make up from last season, this season, he got a veteran.
He's behind it.
Behind
it. Oh, yeah, and they did that for a reason.
A veteran that's been proven to be able to go
they
up in that field.
They did that for a reason.
Job,
right.
So, I'm not going
to. What was the reason why, B?
Well, the reason is that first of all, like why I said, you got Baker's first season. He comes in as a rookie. He does a great job.
Great job.
Had everybody up in arms. Second season, he didn't seem to be right. But honestly, I blame it on Beckham. I really do, because that's the only difference from his first season to the second season. And when you get a player like Beckham that comes to the team, he raises expectations super high.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you also got a rookie head coach. Everybody in Cleveland want to see a winner. And Baker didn't get better last year. He got worse.
He got worse.
That's my thing.
I don't believe it just on – I ain't going to put it on just on Beckham like that. Even though you can, because he didn't come to training camp and get the the reps he needed and get the you know, to build the continuity with Baker that he needed for the next season. Right.
But what I was going to say is that, see, Case Keenum, they went. That was one of the first things they did was go get Case Keenum. And the reasoning behind it is because, and I'm going to tell you, if Baker start this season, the first six games, if Baker is not 4-2, 3-3, you go see Case Keenum.
Oh yeah, myself. If we start off the season 0-2, 0-3, 0-4, pull.
Oh, he gonna have to be pulled. But you go now. Because you done with him though. You gonna be done with him.
You know his whole career, even when he was in college, he left Texas Tech. And came to Oklahoma.
Mm-hmm.
Now every team he went, he walked on
mm-hmm.
and became the star.
The star.
I think he needed Keenum.
He needed pressure.
Well, and I think he do better with pressure
right.
than without pressure.
Right.
Because I think he got comfortable his second season.
When
he came
did.
His first
he
season,
did.
He had, I knew he had pressure on. I got to show what I got.
And he did his job.
The second season, he went all Hollywood on.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so happy that he recognized what he was going wrong with.
But see, I think the Hollywood part, this is the part that kills me, okay? The Hollywood part came from Beckham. Now, I'm not blaming Beckham. Beckham is an awesome receiver. What I'm saying is that when you get a player like Beckham, Beckham is an awesome player.
Right.
He's like having a LeBron or something like that on your team.
Okay.
And when you get a person like this, even though his best friend Landry is there, even though Beckham had 1,000 yards, Beckham didn't have the continuity with Baker. Right. I watch games where Beckham would come out of a route, break be wide open. Baker don't even look his way.
You can see the
frustration on Beckham. He pissed off.
Yeah. Yeah.
When that pass that he caught that got him over 1,000 yards, when he caught that pass, he ran right off the field.
Yeah. But then, it's easier to throw to somebody who you've been throwing with the whole offseason mm-hmm. than to come in and throw to somebody who you're not sure where to put the ball to him. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying?
Right.
You really ain't got to really, if you put the ball anywhere near Beckham,
he's going to catch that.
But I don't think.
That's funny. It sounds like y'all making excuses because.
I don't think Baker.
I mean, Tom Brady didn't have Gronk the whole offseason.
When he came back,
we got to stop making excuses.
He had a weak season without Gronk, too.
If a guy is open, I don't care who it is, get him the ball.
That's true, too.
You know, like, with A.J. Green and the guy they just got rid of, the quarterback they just got rid of, they worked together the all offseason.
Some good years together, though.
Well, I'm talking about last year.
But they had some good years together. Yeah. They had a relationship. Yeah. When you Baker Mayfield and you coming off your rookie season where you done broke the NFL touchdown record for quarterbacks, and then what they go do for you, we go get you the best receiver in the game. Okay, so now everybody, Browns Super Bowl, Browns this, Browns 10-6, Browns 12-4, Browns 11-5.
The team we had.
And didn't do it because I don't blame that on Beckham. I blame that on our coach.
Yeah.
And I blame Becker not improving last year because of the coach. That's where my belief is at.
I blame the coach. I blame Mayfield for going into that Hollywood status that he went into. You know what I'm saying? He had more, as they say, commercials last year than he had touchdowns.
Yeah.
Now, come on, we can't have
that. Yeah.
We can't have that. I think he's going to have to come in, focus in on what he got to do, Everybody focusing on what we got to do, especially our receivers and our running back. Him, Beckham, Higgins, Landry, DePaul, all of them got to get together and get continuity.
Mm-hmm.
We need that. We got to have that, especially with him and Beckham, because we know what Landry going to do.
Right.
We're going to need Beckham for that deep threat.
We're going to need him.
And we got
it. But Beckham got to get it out there.
We got to get it out
there. Because, see, I mean, like the one pass they show that Dre was talking about in double coverage. That wasn't a good pass.
That wasn't a good pass.
Beckham caught it.
He caught it.
Beautiful.
He's back.
But that was a horrible pass.
Because he's back. That's
a horrible pass.
Hey, the one catch that Dwight Clark made that is famous, it wasn't a good pass, but like sometimes.
He caught it, but he wasn't double covered.
But look, sometimes you got to, the quarterback will put it there, and sometimes you got to go make your money.
Yeah, I've never, I see what you said, Dre. We all grew up about in the same era.
Right.
We done seen some great receivers, and we done seen some great quarterbacks. And I do not see Roger Staubach, Dan Fouts, Joe Montana, Steve Young, Dan Marino. I did not see these dudes just deliberately throw into double cover. Deliberately. I've never heard a coach tell a quarterback, man, I don't give a damn, in double covers and triple covers, you throw that ball to Beckham. I've never heard that before.
You left out. I mean, there's some other quarterbacks.
Oh, it's a whole bunch I left out.
I mean, because Randy Moss, I mean, he throw me the damn ball. Throw it up
right.
There.
Right. Terrell Owens was like that.
Terrell Owens was another. So, like, it depends on your personnel.
Brett Favre was like that. He's going to drive it like
you
that
got
all
a quarterback.
Right.
Yeah. But double coverage?
Yeah.
You got a quarter. Well, sometimes. I mean, sometimes.
It's like three dudes down the field and two of them not Cleveland Browns.
I agree with you, some guys
that will make you pay no matter what.
Yeah.
I'm with that. But you know what, from a quarterback that had more interceptions than touchdowns last year, I don't like seeing that.
Yeah, that's a problem.
That's what he was doing.
I believe we should have, you know, it's okay to throw in the double cut with certain receivers. It's not a good thing to do all the time, but with certain receivers, it's okay. But he got a bad habit of wanting to force it a little too much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's not a good thing.
And he throws
too high. We have to learn how to drop it off.
Mm-hmm.
See, we got some running backs in that backfield now.
Mm-hmm.
That if you throw that pass 2 yards to the sideline, mm-hmm. he might break that for 25.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They, you know, right.
So he got to get into the habit of dumping that pass.
That's right.
And to what Dre was saying, you know, with Brady, he didn't have Gump when he left. But you know where he made his living at? Dropping that pass off.
Oh, yeah. Right. Big time. Big time.
And some other running backs, some tight ends, and some other receiver coming across the middle. And I believe until Beckham, Mayfield, Landry, Higgum, Chubb, Hunt get the continuity we need going down deep, we're going to have to drop that pass.
Yeah, he's going to have to. He's going to have to. But see, that's what Beckham was pissed off about. Sometime he did that and at the wrong time.
That's a lot to do with the coaching. If the coach don't call them players and let him know, listen, man, if this not open,
mm-hmm.
hit your drop down.
Right.
You got two drop downs. Right. Now you got two major drop downs.
Mm-hmm.
You got two major drop downs.
They got them. And I don't know, they need to play them both in the same backfield. I hope you see that, because the type of offense.
Do you hope they do?
I hope they do.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And they also drafted a nice fullback. They got a good fullback.
Yeah. So let me ask you, what you think about the two tight end combinations?
Oh, man, I love it.
You know,
but it has nothing to do with Njoku, though. I like the tight end they drafted.
Yeah, but see, and that's like another thing. When Joe Giannoku was gonna leave, he had to be traded.
Yeah, he shouldn't have did that.
I'm like, man, that wasn't a smart move, because when Hopper is in, do you realize, man, when they go into that double tight end, the coverage he gonna have on him?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that he had the potential of at least getting about 900 yards,
oh,
700
my
yards in reception?
My goodness.
Because they're not going to double him like because he hasn't proven himself like that.
And he's gone.
But Harper, they're going to double him.
Oh, they're going to have to.
You better be careful, because what's his
But see, you really can't double anybody.
No,
that's the thing right now. See, you can't – if you double Hooper, then you got Beckham, you got Landry.
Yeah.
You know, you got Kareem Hunt. You got to really play the Cleveland Browns. I'm not going to say one-on-one.
what is your mentality going to be? Is you going to have the mentality you have in Minnesota?
Mm-hmm. You got to.
Hit it downfield. It's not downfield. Drop it off.
Mm-hmm.
It's not downfield, drop it off. If not to the drop off, drop it to the tight end. Not to the tight end, drop it to the running back. If it's not there, just sit it down.
And I think the only problem with the team I see right now is the same thing that all the rest of these teams are going to have. You don't have a preseason. You really had a irregular offseason, period. You know, and it's going to take a little time to get cohesion, you know, and I think the best thing about it is that you're going to see a lot of upsets week one.
Yeah.
You know, because people are just not ready.
And I believe this too here too, B, that it's going to be a good season and everybody going to be on the same level because there's no preseason. So it's going to really, show who really took the offseason seriously.
Thanks for watching The Debate.
I came from drop tops and old school Chevys. Dope boys rolling through, shitting on your heavy. 15s in the trunk, beating down your block. Only 4 years old when Biggie got shot. I remember playing on the block, hanging on the block, young, slinging on the block, getting off them rocks. Now we living better now, Coogee sweater now. But they're still getting colder, we could change the weather now.